everyone. On this video, I'm gonna show you how we do the mean of the group data. There's a different way that you can do it, that you can draw a table and fill up, but you don't get marks for the table. Usually teachers, we do the table so that you can understand what's happening. So here, I'm gonna show you the shorter version of how you do it in an exam to get full marks. Okay, this is a data for a test that learners wrote. So the test was, the total was out of 50. So the frequency, how many learners got from 0 to 10, it's marks, it's not percentage. Yeah, you can tell this was a maths test. Because when you look at the highest one, there are only two learners got from 40 to 50. So definitely it was maths. But this is a good class when you look at their marks. Another thing with group data, when they say 0 to 10, when they say two learners got 0 to 10, you don't know exactly which mark did they get. Did they get 5? Did they get 0? These two. Did they get 8? Did they get 9? That's why when we calculate the mean is the average. We say is the estimated mean. Because each of these, when you say 13, you don't know if 13 of them got 15, 15, 15 or 12 and 19. And we don't know exactly. That's why we call it a estimated mean. Okay, another thing with a mean of a group data, it will not be a mean of these values. These values are the frequency of learners that got from 0 to 10. 13 learners got from 10 to 20. 14 learners got from 20 to 30. So you don't expect that the mean will be the average of this. No, it's not. Because this is the number of learners, the frequency of learners that got those marks. So I'm expecting that the mean will be higher compared to that. But let's calculate it, and then when we get to that, I'll show you what I mean.
Okay.
So when you calculate the mean of group data, you say this is the interval. So you add this one and that one. So you're going to say 0 plus 10, which is 10. Then you divide it by 2. We call that a mean point. So you add this and then divide by 2. 10 divided by 2 is 5. That 5, you multiply with the frequency of that table. Then this is for the first interval. Then you're going to add. You're going to add it you add the intervals 10 plus 20 is 30. Divide by 2, it's 15. Multiplied by the frequency, it's 13. You add the next interval, 20 plus 30 is 50. 50 divided by 2 is 25. 25 times the frequency is 14. Then add the next. 30 plus 40 is 70. 70 divided by 2 is 35. Please use your calculator. 35. When you're in an exam, you have lots of stress. You'll make unnecessary mistakes. So I'm not writing an exam. That's why I'm not using a calculator. When I all the time use a calculator. Then the next interval. 40 plus 50 is 90. 90 divided by 2 is 45. This is the midpoint, and then you multiply that by 2. Now, you remember with the mean or the average, the mean is the average. The mean of the ungrouped data, you'll add all the marks and divide by the total. Same thing here. You've added all the frequencies and the midpoint. You have to divide everything by the total of the frequency. So you have to add this and get the total of the frequency and then divide by that. I'm going to use a calculator for this. I'm not sure if I'm getting it right. So it's 2 plus 13, which is 15, plus 14, plus 7, plus 2. So the total is 38. So it means learners in this class, there were 38 learners. And then this 38 learners got this range of marks. Okay, so the estimated mean, you're going to punch all of that in your calculator and then divide it by 38. Okay, if you have a natural display calculator, go to fraction button and then you do a fraction and then you do the denominator. Punch everything as it's written here with the brackets and then divide that by 38. If you don't have a natural display, it's fine. You say 5 times 2, then you say plus. If you say plus, it's going to do... what mass is going to multiply first before it adds. So you can do all of that times 13 plus 25 times 14 plus 35 times 7 plus 45 times 2, and then you say equals to, it gives me 890. But for safety, I'm going to check it again if I'm going to get 890. 5 times 2 plus 15 times 13 plus 25 times 14 plus 35 times 7 plus 45 times 2. It's giving me 890. So you're going to have 890 divided by 38. I don't think you're going to get marks for writing this. You can just straight divide by 38. So the estimated mean, usually when you look at memos, they'll write an equal sign like this. This means estimated. It's not accurate because you don't know exactly what marks did they get. So the estimated mean is 23.42. Now, there's no child that's going to get 23, so it means averagely, they are getting 23.42 out of 50. So this test was good for them. Most of them got an average of 46%. So that's quite good for a maths test. If it was a maths test, then it's quite good. So this is how you go about. This is how you calculate the mean. And this in grade 10, it can give you up to 4 marks. In grade 11 and in grade 12, sometimes they do it 3 marks or 2. So, but these marks are that you can actually get. Thank you for watching. This is the end of our lesson.